everyone. I'm super excited about today. We have Lauren, who's going to be teaching our hour-long yoga class, and we also have Frankie here. So we are super excited. I hope you enjoy class today.
All right, everybody. So let's start lying down on our backs in a Shavasana position. So allow for the feet to flop. Maybe take the arms a little bit wider. And then just begin to close the eyes and take some deep breaths in and out through the nose. Coming to a place of mindful presence. Working towards diminishing the thoughts in the mind. Finding yourself in the here and now. So one of my favorite quotes is from Maya Angelou. I long, as does every human being, to find myself at home wherever I'm at. So through our practice, we want to think about when we feel discomfort or we feel like we want to maybe shift out of a pose, can we be at home? Can we find ourselves at home? Or in essence, use your practice as a homecoming, back to yourself, to your true nature. And on your next breath, let's start to pull the knees into the chest. Just wrap your arms around the outside of the thighs. Just rock a little bit from side to side. At this point, you can begin to start to incorporate your Ujjayi pranayama, breathing in and out through the nose, that soft whisper at the back of your throat. And then pause here. Open the arms out to the side like a T, and let's begin to take a supine twist. So the legs drop over towards the right. The gaze can come in whichever direction feels best for your neck. Start to pull the knees back into the chest and over to the other side. Now remember, you can keep the knees kind of at the height of the hip or pulled in a little bit more towards the chest if you want more flexion of the spine. If the lower back is tender, keep them maybe even lower than. Let's pull the legs back into the chest. Switch the grip and place the hands on the backs of the thighs. And start to rock on the full length of your spine, forward and back. And eventually you'll come up, cross your shins, roll over your knees, and come to all fours. From all fours, let's take some cat and cows, inhaling as you come forward. Exhaling as you round your back. And then anything that you intuitively feel would be good in your body in this moment. Let's take one more round. Finish up wherever you're at. Find a neutral spine. Start to press through the palms and find protraction of the upper back. So the shoulder blades start to puff and round. There you go. Now keeping this engagement here, see how it's nice and filled the space. You'll continue to press through your palms and then hover your knees about an inch off the floor, keeping the toes untucked. But feeling the lower abdomen begin to contract. Gaze is straight down. Breath is consistent, and then exhale, lower the knees, and press back. Taking a couple breaths here, shifting the hips back towards your heels, maybe a gentle sway side to side as you coax the buttocks down, and reach with your arms, find length through the sides of your body. next breath, lift your gaze, begin to shift back forward into your tabletop position, and then the same thing that we did before, start to press and find that roundness of the upper back, engaging the rhomboids, and then press down through the palms and let the knees hover off the floor about 2 inches. Now this time, see if you can get your right foot to lift, as if you're taking the heel towards your buttock. Doesn't have to go super high. Holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Drop the knee, hips to your heels, child's pose once again. Starting to bring the awareness to the physical body, to our core, the center of our power, our strength. And then again, shift back forward to all fours. Dome the upper back, press through the palms, hover the knees, and then lift the left foot. Good. Holding for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Release. This time, tuck your toes under, lift your hips up for downward dog. While you're in downward dog, allow the heels to descend towards the mat. It's okay if they don't touch. Pull the floating ribs in, filling up the space of the lower back. And then press through the palms, a little lift of the forearms. Let your head dangle in between the biceps. Now on your next breath, begin to tiptoe all the way to the top of the mat. As you come to Uttanasana, just let your head fall. Tuck the chin in. Hands can dangle in any position. And then keeping the core engaged, let's begin to round up to standing and bring your hands to your heart. Taking Samasthitihi, bowing the chin in towards the chest. Several breaths here as we take a moment for your dedication, intention, your sankalpa. Maybe just say an om to yourself. And then start to peek open the eyes, release the hands, move through Surya Namaskar A. So inhale, circle the arms up and over your head. Exhale as you begin to fold forward. Keep the navel pulled in. Ardha Uttanasana, flat back as you inhale. And then the exhale to either step or hop back, begin to move through your vinyasa. All the way back to downward facing dog. Pausing here. Again, try to find some length of the sit bones up. The quadriceps are engaging, stretching and lengthening the backs of your legs. One more breath here. And then begin to bend into your legs. Look forward, and then step or hop to the top of the mat. Flat back when you arrive, and then the exhale to release. Inhale, rounds up to standing, and your hands come to your heart. And we'll take that again. Inhale, circle the arms up. Exhale as you begin to fold. Flat back as you inhale. And then exhale to chaturanga, so stepping or hopping back. Lowering down with control, elbows hugged in. Inhale to your back bend. And then exhale to downward facing dog. And again, we take several breaths here. Good, one more. And then bend into your legs, look forward. Step or hop to the top of the mat. Flat back as you arrive, and then release. Inhale, rounds up to standing, hands to your heart as you exhale. And then again, inhale, arms up and over your head. Exhale as you fold. Flat back, inhale, half position. Exhale to chaturanga, lower down with control. Inhale to your upward facing dog or even a cobra. Exhale to downward facing dog. And pausing in the downward facing dog. Remember, the heels are trying to work their way down, and then maybe slightly with a micro movement outward so you feel the hamstrings even fire up a little bit more. Now inhale, shift forward into a high plank position. And then very slowly we'll make our way all the way down to the floor. Now as you get to the ground, take your legs together unless it's a contraction of some pain in the lower back. And bring your hands down by your side for Shalabhasana A. So palms are going to face up towards... Yeah, there we go. Keep the legs active but not lifting. And just take your chest up off the floor. Press the tops of the hands into the mat to assist in lifting, but really focus on the shoulders and the back muscles lifting you. And the diaphragm's gonna press into the floor, you'll get a little bit more lift. And then exhale, lower down. Flip your palms back like you would chaturanga. Inhale to upward facing dog. And exhale to downward facing dog. Bend into your legs, look forward. Hop to the top of the mat. Flat back, exhale, fold. Inhale, rounds up to standing. Exhale, hands to your heart. Now let's take the hands behind the back. Interlace your fingers, start to open up your chest. Inhale, look up, and then as you exhale, you can fold. Feel free to bend your knees a little bit. Tuck your chin in towards your chest. Take your arms up and over your back. Come closer to with the chest to your thighs. Maybe the legs straighten out a little bit, but feel free to keep those bend in the knees. Shift the weight forward so we're not locking out the legs. One more breath. Press down through your feet. Come on up to standing. As you come to standing, circle those arms up and over your head. Interlace your fingers again. Flip your palms. Reach up out of your waist. Press your hips forward and take a little bit of a back bend. Exhale, release your hands as you come back to standing. Inhale to Utkatasana, your chair pose. And then exhale, begin to fold. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, flat back. And then hands plant, exhale, step or hop back. We meet a downward facing dog. Take your modifications as you need them. Right foot will step forward in between your hands. Back heel goes flat. Inhale to warrior one. Come up. And then as you exhale, hands down to the floor. Step back and cycle through a vinyasa. And then left foot steps forward, warrior one. Inhale as you come up. And then exhale, hands to the floor. Step back and take your vinyasa. Pausing in downward dog for a couple breaths. Now inhale, shift forward to a high plank position. From your high plank, we're going to go into a modified side plank. So drop down to your right knee and then lift your left arm up and roll to the edge of the inner edge of your left arm. Let's work on neutralizing the pelvis so the flesh of the buttocks is drawing down as the hips even off. Your gaze is going to come up. And then if you want to shift a little bit further forward, feel free to lift the left leg. Good. And then as you exhale, release the left hand down to the floor, left foot. Come back to high plank. But hold your high plank for a moment. Press through the balls of the feet just like we did earlier. Can we puff the upside, the back side of the body to support the front side of the body? And then let's go to the other side. So drop down to the left knee, roll the foot down, lift up your left arm. Good. Find that neutral pelvis. Shift a little bit further forward, lift the left leg if you did on the other side. Gaze towards the top hand. And then as you exhale, release the right hand, right foot, come back to high plank. high plank position. And then exhale to downward dog or take a vinyasa. From downward dog, bend into your legs, hop forward or step. Flat back as you get there. And then exhale to release. Inhale, Utkatasana. And then straighten your legs and bring your hands towards your heart. Good, let's do that again. Inhale, Utkatasana. Exhale as you begin to fold. Flat back, inhale, lengthen the spine. And then exhale to step or hop back, move through vinyasa. Okay, right foot comes forward for warrior one. Inhale, reach up, hips are squared, back foot's pressing down. And then exhale, hands to the floor. Step back and take your vinyasa again. And then left foot's gonna step forward in between your hands. Inhale, come up. And then exhale, hands to the floor. Step back, and again, we cycle through. We meet in downward dog, or take whatever modifications you need. Pausing in your downward dog position. And then again, inhale, shift forward to high plank. We're gonna roll over to our side plank, this time unmodified. So roll to the right side, left arm is going to lift up. So you can either stack the feet or have one in front of each other if you need a little bit of help. Of course, you can drop back down to the knee. And then again, can we find the pelvis even towards the side, a nice lift through the side body. The shoulders are drawing down and the gaze is coming up. Exhale, left hand comes to the floor, we find high plank. And then we roll right over to the other side. Good. Same thing. Work on the pelvis being neutral. Nice lift through here. Top arm is reaching up. Gaze is coming up. Good. And then exhale. Release the left hand down to the floor. High plank. And then again, an option to take a vinyasa or go right to downward dog. From your downward dog position, bend into your legs, step or hop to the top of the mat. Ardha Uttanasana, inhale, look forward, and then exhale, release. Utkatasana on your inhale, and then straighten the legs, take your hands to your heart. Okay, one more Sun V variation, inhale, Utkatasana. Exhale as you begin to fold. Flat back as you inhale, extend the spine. Exhale to Chaturanga. Inhale to your back bend. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take the right foot forward in between your hands, warrior one. This time we're gonna hold. As we hold this position, think of the right hip crease pulling back and notice that the bend of the knee probably diminished a little bit, so bend back in. Wrap the left hip forward, press through the left heel, engage the quadricep, and then reach up with your arms, lengthen out of your waist, maybe the gaze comes up. And then as you exhale, open into warrior two, adjust your stance as you need to. Now hips are gonna be facing the side. Think of tucking the right buttocks under a little bit, pressing through the back heel, navel's pulled in, shoulders are relaxed. Then start to straighten out through the front leg for your triangle pose. You may want to shorten your stance, otherwise keep it wide. But your left hip presses back as you reach forward the right hand. Take it down towards your shin to the floor, maybe a big toe. If you need a block, grab a block here. Begin to stack the shoulders. Find some length on the underside as well. And then notice if the weight is rolling to the edge of the right foot, press down a little bit more through the mound of the right big toe. One more breath. Use your legs, come on back up to warrior two. And then from your warrior two position, we're gonna cartwheel the hands to the floor. As you cartwheel the hands down, take your right knee to your right tricep. Hold it there. Yeah. Feel free to stay in this position for five breaths, or begin possibly to shift forward into a little bit of an arm balance. So the left elbow comes in towards the side, chaturanga arms, the gaze is looking forward, the back foot begins to lift, maybe, and then exhale to chaturanga, we're downward dog. Left foot's gonna step forward in between the hands for triangle, for warrior one. Good, so we're holding this position again. Sorry, I need to go. Hips are wrapping forward, lengthen up out of the waist. Good, possibly the drishti, your focus is looking upward. And then exhale, let's come into warrior two. Adjust your back foot if you need to. Engagement through the back leg, so we lift to Mula Bandha, keeping the front knee nice and bent. And then triangle pose, so start to straighten to the left leg. Right hip presses back, reach forward with the left hand, and then begin to stack the shoulders. And finding a little bit more even length through the torso if possible, so keeping the lower abdomen contracted, Uddiyana Bandha. And again, the gaze comes up, press through the back heel, and lift up through the left quadricep. And then press down through your feet, come back up to standing. Find warrior two once again. And then on the exhalation, cartwheel the hands to the ground, left knee to left tricep. Maybe that's where you stay. You want a little bit more, bend your elbows and hold. You want a little bit more, you find the balance. And then possibly shoot back into chaturanga or go right to downward facing dog. From your downward facing dog, take a couple breaths here, breathing in and out through the nose. Notice if the mind has started to wander or possibly the breath's a little bit choppier from those last cycle of poses. Now inhale, shift forward to high plank again. We're gonna go to side plank once more, and then we're gonna try lifting the leg. So if you wanna modify it, you can drop down to the right knee, otherwise we're gonna roll to the right side. Stacking the shoulders, and again, this is a nice place to stop, or you can drop to the knee. Again, the weight shifts a little bit further forward, and then see if you can lift your left leg. If you have the ability to grab for the big toe or any other variation, feel free to, and then extend the leg up towards the ceiling. Beautiful. Good. Hips up a little bit higher. There we go. One more breath. As you exhale, release high plank. Hold. Prepare, and let's go to the other side. Rolling to the left, stacking the shoulders, hips are even. Feel free to stay here. Maybe drop to the knee. Top leg's going to lift. If you want to grab for the toe, grab for the toe and extend the foot up. Beautiful. Lift a little bit more. Try not to press the buttocks back too much. And then exhale, we release high plank. And then again, the optional vinyasa. Let's pause in your downward facing dog. Inhale, shift forward to high plank. Lower down to your bellies. As you come to your abdomen, take your arms out to the side like a T. We'll come into our shoulder stretch. So let's roll over to the right side to start. And we come into what we call log formation, everything stacked. And then we can start to move into some variations, just like Frankie's doing right here, where she's bending the leg, bringing the foot possibly to the floor. So we're working on opening up through the right pectoral. If you want a little bit more, you can take the left hand behind the back towards your sacrum, or possibly to even bind your fingertips. Good, but focus on that broadening of the collarbones. Maybe a little rotation through the trunk. One more breath here. And then start to release, come back onto your belly, and we'll go over to the other side. Arms out, and then to the left. Maybe bending into the top leg, bringing the foot to the floor as you bend the knee. want to add in the shoulder both sides. Take your right hand up and behind you. Holding it here. Open the chest. One more breath. And then exhale, release. Come back onto your abdomen. Take your hands like you would chaturanga again. Inhale to upward facing dog or cobra. And then exhale to downward facing dog. Bend into your legs, look forward, step or hop to the top of the mat. Flat back, and then release. Inhale to Utkatasana. Straighten your legs and bring your hands to your heart. Take a moment to reset. Then bring your feet to hip distance for Parangustasana. So maybe just a little bit wider. There we go. Hands towards your hips. Inhale, lengthen up first. And then as you exhale, fold. Let's grab onto the big toes. If you need to bend your knees, but drop your head down, tucking your chin in towards your chest. Roll the weight towards the balls of the feet. Once again, we lift up through the upper thighs. The sit bones or outer hips are squeezing into the midline to feel so that you feel stable. And the neck is long here. Inhale, look forward, release your toes, take your hands underneath your feet for Padahastasana. So feet all the way up to the wrist creases. Again, your knees can be bent. And then once you get into position, drop the crown of the head back down towards the floor. Shift the weight a little bit further forward. There we go. Lift up through the thighs. Next breath, gaze forward. Release your hands. We're going to take the left hand outside of the left foot. The right hand's going to grab onto your big toe with your middle index finger. And then we're going to lift the right leg straight out to the side at about the height of your hip. Good. Try not to shift too much, so firm the outer left hip in. If this is easy for you, possibly lift the left hand and take it towards your heart or your hip. Exhale, release the right foot down. Pedal out the legs, and then we'll switch sides. So right hand comes out to the side slightly in front, grab onto the big toe on the left foot. Shift the weight into the right leg, engage the core, and then lift the leg out to the side. Good. See if you can get the leg higher and the hips still stacked over the ankle if possible. Maybe your right hand wants to lift on this side. Maybe not. And then exhale, release the foot down. Inhale, flat back. And let's prepare for a Bakasana. So take your hands shoulders distance, bring your palms flat to the floor, and then start to take your knees to the backs of your arms and hug it in. This might be where you stay. If you're going further, start to shift your shoulders past your wrists, possibly lifting up your feet. Otherwise, stay right here, hugging the knees in, navel pulled in, that protraction, that roundness of the upper back again. Feel free to tap the toes and shoot it back or shoot right back into Chaturanga. Good. Move through Vinyasa. We'll meet in Downward Dog once again. Your right leg is going to lift. Stack your right hip over your left and bring your heel towards your buttock. Open the hips out to the side. Press through the palms. Make sure you're not sinking into your shoulders. And then even off your hips, step your right foot forward in between your hands for crescent lunge. Inhale, arms come up. And then let's try to take the palms together. So bring them slightly in front of your face instead of directly over your head. Really engaging more through the pectorals and feeling the upper arm bones wrap kind of out and in. Then start to think of the back ribs pressing in. Begin to lengthen up, and then we're going to take it back as far as we feel comfortable. And then as we exhale, open into Warrior Two. So carve open the arms, back heel down. And then take your hands to your hips. turn and pivot the right foot to the side so we're in our wide leg position. Inhale, find some length through the spine, and then as you exhale, begin to fold and take your hands underneath your shoulders. Let's take A position, so flat back, inhale first, then exhale, fold, walk your hands back in line with your ankles and point the crown of the head towards the floor. But again, we shift the weight a little bit further forward. The sensation of the hip crease is lifting. The sit bone squeezing to stabilize. One more breath here. Inhale, flat back. We're going to stay low. Turn and pivot your right foot back forward. Take your chest with you. And then drop down onto the left knee. So we're going to come into kind of like your lizard or get-go pose. So take your hands on the inside. Walk your right foot all the way to the edge of the mat. Maybe even point the toes away a little bit. You can stay up on your hands or drop down to your forearms. And then if you'd like to make this a little bit more active, you can tuck the back toes under, lifting the thigh off the ground. And then think of the spine pulling forward. Yeah. Nice length through the whole spine. Holding for a couple more breaths here. One more, and then drop back down to your left knee. So we're gonna kind of go back to that arm balance that we did before, but this time the leg's gonna be straight, but we'll attempt it. So come onto the hands. Take your right arm, so Frankie, you're gonna see her, we'll take the arm underneath, so she wants it up nice and high on the shoulder if possible. Then she'll start to tuck the back toes under, lifting the knee off the floor. You may have wanted to start there, actually. Uh-oh, she's going down already. First, straighten this leg forward.
Before I do this.
Exactly. Good, so see how she has this leg nice and engaged. Toes are pointing, Padabandha. Elbows are gonna start to hug in as she shifts forward, not down. So it's forward first for your Kundalini. Maybe the back foot lifts, it might not, that's okay. Beautiful. And then try shooting it back to Vinyasa. Now we can do that in stages too. So we're here, we take the arm underneath. It's, for some of us, it's gonna be hard to lift the leg, so you can wiggle, 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 wiggle until you can get it back, then hold, and then just shoot back. And we need a downward dog, so take a vinyasa if you'd like. Okay, left leg is going to lift. Stack the left hip over the right heel towards your buttocks. Good. Press through the palms. Open up the hip. Now even off the hips, step your left foot forward in between your hands. Crescent lunge. So the back heel stays lifted. Inhale, torso upright. Now if the lower back is tender here, a nice little bend in the knee or a micro bend will be good. And then same thing as we did before. Let's bring the palms together a little bit in front of the face. Reach up and find length. Good. And then start to take it back. Next breath, we come on back up. Open into warrior two. Good. Turn and pivot towards the side for your wide leg position again. This time, we'll take the hands behind the back. Interlace the fingers, open up the chest. Now before we fold forward, let's take a little bit of a back bend, maybe a deep one for some of us. And then exhale, fold. Take your arms up and over your head as the crown of the head points towards the floor.
Ooh, baby, baby, it's a wild world.
You could always use a strap here or a towel.
It's hard to get by, just wanna smile.
And then on your next breath, press down through your legs, come all the way back up to standing. As you come back up to standing, release your hands. We're going to take them to the hips, inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, fold, going to D, grabbing onto the big toes this time. So grab onto the big toes with your middle and index finger. Inhale, find length, and then as you exhale, crown of the head towards the floor. Nice little bend in the elbows. See how both of them have the elbows lifting up. Neck is nice and long. We're shifting the weight forward into the balls of the feet. Another two breaths here. And then inhale, lift the gaze and release your hands and bring them underneath your shoulders. Okay, so we're gonna do a little bit of play of just finding the lower abdomen. So I'll use Frankie. She's gonna take her hands flat to the floor, but not directly underneath the shoulders, just a little bit further out. Good. So then she's gonna begin to shift forward, trying to get her hips high and onto the balls of the feet. Beautiful. And then you just exhale and you let the hips come down, the heels come down. You're gonna do that a couple times. Some of you might feel comfortable taking a little hop, or maybe even just lifting one foot up, bending into the leg, bringing the heel towards your buttocks. But you should feel your core engage every time you shift forward. Inhale, flat back. Turn and pivot towards your left foot. Drop down to your right knee. We're going to go back into that lizard get-go pose. So you can keep the knee lifted, you can keep it down, you can stay on your hands, or maybe drop to the forearm. So remember, you want to work with what's going on with your body. So the shapes are meant to serve you, not the other way around. Okay, about three more full cycles of breath here. A beautiful breath. Okay, drop down to the knee for the right knee for a moment. Come back up onto your hands. Okay, so from here, let's tuck the right toes under, lift the knee off the floor. So that gives us our hips a little bit higher so that we can wiggle the left arm underneath and get it high up on the arm as much as possible, just at least above the elbow. Now this might be where you stay. If you want to go a little bit deeper, you're going to try to point your left toe first. So the leg is engaged. Then don't look down, keep looking forward. Start to shift your shoulders forward once you get to your max degree. Bend the elbows into the sides of your body. Potentially find a little bit of a lift and then hop it back. There's also a transition to chin stand from there if anybody's advanced that's practicing that wants to go there. And just take a couple breaths in your downward facing dog. Alright, lift the right leg up. Let's bring the right knee in towards the chest for your pigeon prep pose. So the right knee hugs in towards midline. And then the right ankle comes more in front of your left hip. We lower down. Okay, so work on squaring off your hips. And before we come down, start to point your left toes back behind you. Get a little bit more length. Take your hands towards the outsides of your hips and try to find a little bit of a lift into the back bend here. So the full pose, your Ekapadarajo Kapotasana, is a back bend. And then as we exhale, we fold. And we'll just focus on that little bit more of a passive stretch than the full version, and focus on that outer right hip. So we want to square off the hips as much as possible. If you're having too much sensation in the right hip, you could always lean to the right glute and bend into your left leg. Feel free to even reach the arms forward, coming all the way down. Two more cycles of breath. Okay, let's take the hands underneath the shoulders, bring the torso back upright. And we're gonna come into a little bit of a twist. So we're gonna take the right elbow towards the right foot. So you can either bring the elbow point in front of your foot and then take your hands to prayer, or if you have the flexibility, you can take the tricep into the sole of the foot and then bring the hands together in prayer. Now use that leverage of the arm into the foot to increase the sensation in the outer hip, and then also a nice beautiful twist through the spine. Good. The shoulders drop down, the left shoulder pulls back, and we're twisting, looking up and over the shoulder. Good. One more breath here. And then start to unwind. Take your hands underneath your shoulders again. Tuck your left toes under. Lift first, hovering the right leg into your chest. Good. Take your right knee to your right tricep. Hold it there. And then take it over to the left and hold it there. Get it to touch if you can. Then back to center and go back to your three-legged downward dog. So lift your right leg up nice and high. And if you want to open the hip, you can. Or just stay here, dropping the chest. And then exhale, release the right foot. Left leg is going to lift, and we'll do that on the other side. So left knee comes in towards the chest. Start to hug towards the midline. Ankle comes more in front of the right hip now. And then start to come on down, squaring off the hips. Find a little bit more length in the back leg. Good. Bring the hands towards the hips, or outside of the hips. And then open and lift the chest. Good. And then come on back and fold it forward to your degree. Okay, three more breaths here. Back up onto your hands, take your torso upright, and let's take that twist. So now the left elbow either comes right in front of the foot, or somewhere around that area, or all the way into the full twist, tricep to the sole of the foot. Press the hands to the heart, and then even though we're opening to the side a little bit, can we still make that right hip heavy? So we're really working through the thoracic to open the spine versus dipping the hips in some way. Nice and long, last breath. And then start to unwind. Take your hands back underneath your shoulders. Tuck your right toes under, lift the knee and hover. Hold it there. Left knee to left tricep, get it to touch. Then over to the right. And then back to center, extend the leg up to three-legged downward dog. And then any variation that suits you here, maybe bend into the leg or just stay here focusing on the hamstring. And then on the exhale, let's release the left foot down. Pause in downward dog for several breaths. Downward facing dog. We're going to make our way to our seat. So you can either drop to the knees and swing the legs forward. If you have a hop through, feel free to hop to your bottom. And you're going to extend the legs out straight for Paschimottanasana, your forward fold. So flex the feet back towards your face. And let's go for A today. So you're going to take your peace fingers and grab onto the big toes. Inhale, find length first. And then exhale, start to fold. The feet are active, the thighs are rolling in, the navel's pulled towards the spine, and then the chest comes nice and down. On your next breath, inhale, look towards your feet, and then exhale, release. You're going to take your torso upright. And we'll do either reverse tabletop, or you can do it with your legs straight. So take the soles of the feet to the floor if you're modifying. Otherwise, the legs are going to stay straight. Hands about 6 inches behind you. And then lift your hips up for your Parvottanasana. And then try to get your toes to touch. So the way to get them to touch is to roll the shins inward. Lift up more through and get the hips a little higher. And then exhale, lower down. How does that feel in your shoulders? All right, taking the right foot back by your hip. So bend into the right leg, top of the foot to the floor. So Tiryanga Mukha Pada. So left foot's engaged, hips are trying to stay as squared as possible. For some of us, we're gonna lean towards one side, so try to get that right hip crease down. Again, we'll fold over the left leg, grabbing for the inner and outer edge of the foot or possibly binding the wrist. So again, notice if that right hip lifted. Tilt the chin down, but still look at the toes. Bind of your hands, come back up to seated with your chest. So we're going to take the right leg and open it out to the side for our Parigasana. So take your knee, open it towards the pole, keep the foot where it wants. There you go. So you want to have a nice little, basic, kind of like almost like a wider L. From here to start, just so that we get a nice rotation through the chest, we're going to twist towards the right leg. As we twist, let's start to take the left shoulder down on the inside of the thigh. Again, we're using that kind of as leverage to open the chest. Good, and then take the top arm up and over so you can just reach or eventually find the foot. Once you've found the foot, maybe open the chest, or even if you didn't find the foot. Start to unwind out of your shape. Keep your right leg in the same position, just pull the knee back forward. And then we're going to work on taking a vinyasa out. So start to lean back a little bit, lift your left leg up towards the ceiling. Good. Take your hands to the outside of your hips. So we're using this as slight momentum. The thigh comes towards the chest to engage Uddiyana Bandha. Then on the next breath, we're going to start to shift forward, press,
and hop it back.
Are you kidding? Or swing it back.
Wow, okay.
Well, that was good.
We have the other side to practice. Yeah, so lots of fun. Okay, let's make our way back to your seat. We'll go right to Tiryanga Mukha Pada, or Triyanga Mukha Pada, whatever you know it as. Left foot back by your hip. Hips square, so it's the left hip that may want to lift, so try to take that down. Yeah, there we go. Inhale, and then exhale, we fold over the legs. You can reach the arms up if you need to find length. Fold over the legs, take the chest towards your thigh. Let's inhale, take the torso upright, and we'll go into our gate pose. So the left knee opens out to the side. Good. Take a little bit of a twist so we can get the right shoulder on the inside deeper. Yeah. Now start to dip down, reach the left arm up and over. If the foot's available, take it, but don't worry about it. Grab from the outer edge if you can, and open the chest. Let's come on up, point the left knee forward. Okay, so lean back a little bit. You don't have to, but it just helps you find your bandhas. So lift the leg up a little bit, lean back. You can also use momentum that way too. Then we're gonna shift forward, press, hop it back, really nice. Hey, you will get there. From downward dog, make your way back to your seat. Let's take Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet together, knees drop out to the side, thumbs over the arches of the feet, fingers wrap around the top, open the feet up, inhale, lengthen, and then exhale, fold. Now think of your chin coming to the floor out in front of you. When you're in this position, it may seem counterintuitive, but the femurs are actually internally rotating, protecting those knees. Chest is getting nice and long. Good. Knees are coming down towards the floor. They may not. Both of these yogis have pretty open hips. Okay, so from here, when you're going to take the chest upright and go right into Navasana, so your boat pose. So come up, don't use your arms unless you need to. Extend the legs out. Now you can keep them bent like Frankie just had a second ago, or straighten. But we want to close this gap just a little bit to, again, keep the lower abdomen contracted. But holding for another 3, 2, 1. Cross your right shin over your left nice and tight. Take your hands to the floor and lift your seat off the ground. Maybe the feet lift, maybe they don't. That's okay. Just lift your bottom. There we go. Back down, boat number 2. Remember, you start to fatigue and you compromise the shape. Just bend your knees. Draw the shoulders down away from your face. Gaze down at the toe line. For another 3, 2, 1. Left crosses over now. Press down, lift something up. It might just be one cheek. Then back down, last boat. But holding for 5, 4, 3. Notice if you're clenching. Smile. When you smile, it releases the palate. Let's go to low boat. Ooh. Try taking your arms over your head if you want bonus points. Holding for another 3, 2, 1. Plop it down. Oh, that's the right response. You got to sigh it out. Okay, so just pause here for a second. We are going to move into our back bend. So bridge or wheel. So bending into the legs, bring the feet to the floor. Feet are hips distance and close towards the glutes. Wiggle your shoulders underneath if you're going into bridge. And then press down through your feet, lift your hips up. You can keep your hands where they are or possibly interlace the fingers, pointing the knuckles forward, trying to ground the hands down. And then don't allow the knees to open. They're going to stay hips distance, so isometrically hugging them in. The flesh of the glutes is pulling forward. The heels are pressing down. One more breath here. And then exhale, lower it down. So we got 2 more of those. So coming back into your bridge, or maybe taking your full order down your asana, flipping the palms by your shoulders. Hugging the elbows in, make sure they don't go out so wide. If you find that when you take the arms over, the elbows open, do a little micro rotation of your hands outward to keep those elbows in line. And then lift on up. And holding it here. If you're in your full wheel, think of pressing your heels into the floor so that some of the weight shifts back and opens the chest even more. And then exhale, lower it down. One more time. Set yourself up. We're going into it. All right. Try it. Press down and lift up. Keep pressing. One more breath here. And then exhale, lower it down. As you lower it down, come into Supta Baddha Konasana. So soles of the feet together, knees drop out to the side, let the lower back relax. Smooth down the breath. If it's become choppy, lots of times in our back bend, we tend to hold. Find your breath again. Now close the knees. If you need a deeper counter stretch, you can take a forward fold. Otherwise, we'll just pull the legs into the chest. Or a happy baby. Okay, so from this position, extend your legs up towards the ceiling. This is where you can stay in a Viparita Karani position for your inversion, or take your feet up and over your head into plow. So it's nice to start in plow first to get your hips over your shoulders. So take the feet up and over, try to get them to the floor. Then once we get the hips so that they're somewhat over our shoulders, we'll take the hands to the lower back. And then legs both at the same time, bring them up towards the ceiling. Now as we come into this position, allow some of the weight to come into the elbows and the shoulders so it's not so far by the throat. And then try to lengthen up. And come a little bit more towards the top of your mat. There we go. Beautiful. Couple more breaths in this position. And then start to lower your legs over your head back into plank. And once you get your toes to the floor, or if it's challenging to get them to the floor, bend your knees a little bit. And then release your hands. You can either take them palms flat or you can even bind them again. And let's walk the feet over towards the right side. So just getting into the lower back a little deeper. Up the QL. And then come on back to the center, over to the other side. And then back into the middle. Karna Pindasana. So drop the knees either to your forehead or bring your shins towards the floor outside of your head. Hugging the ears, your ear pressure bones. The hands can stay where they are. You can bind them. Some people like to wrap them behind by the calves to help assist the shins coming down. And then release your variations with your hands. Start to roll on out one vertebra at a time. As we come down, go right into fish. So start to lower down. Your hips come to the floor, the legs extend out. Then press into the forearms, arch the back, and come to the crown of the head. So if you're having a hard time getting your head to the floor, your hands are probably just a little bit the shoulders are too much over the elbows. So wiggle your fingers, maybe slightly past your hips a little bit to decrease the angle of the shoulder and the elbow, and maybe the head will come to the floor. Keep that nice arch in the back. Opening up through the throat. And then from here, so this is your fish pose, your Matsyasana. We'll go to Uttana Parasana. It's a different pose. Legs lift, head stays the same. Lift them a little higher. There you go. Now point your hands towards your toes with the palms together in prayer. Maybe not. And then lower it down, press the forearms into the floor, and tuck your chin in and come on down. From here, let's pull the knees into the chest and give yourself a little rock side to side. Okay. So from here, we're going to take a vinyasa of your choice. Let's take a vinyasa of your choice. You're going to make your way to all fours. So after we've done our vinyasa, we come down onto the knees, all fours, and we'll set up for our headstand. So let's take the forearms to the floor and interlace the fingers. Now you want to make sure that the elbows are about shoulder distance, they're not sliding out too wide. You can untuck your pinky that's on the interlace. And then a couple things to note. We don't want the forearms to roll out, so make sure they're nice and firm into the mat. You can see that here. And then the thumbs are just loosely kind of together. The crown of the head's gonna come to the floor and the flesh of the thumbs is coming back to the head. Now you wanna make sure you're on the crown of the head, your chin's not tucked in too much or the other way. And from here, just try by tucking your toes under, lifting your hips up into a downward dog position. And this might be where you stay. If you feel comfortable, start walking the feet in. And then focus again, keep pressing the forearms into the floor, engaging through the shoulder girdle. Now she's going to start to come on up. If you can, you can try a pike like Frankie, knees bent, or one leg at a time. Then point up to the ceiling with your toes, belly is in. We have five more breaths. Okay, last full breath. Now see if you can either bring the knees back into the chest or lower with the legs to your B position. So legs together in one piece. Or you can do some fun things with your legs too. Good, Frankie, hold it here. So we're working on holding this. Notice how her hips slightly past the shoulders. This angle is coming really close together. That's what you need. And then from here, we're going to take it back up into headstand. One breath or five, or maybe more if you can. Good. And then lower down with control. Child's pose. Try not to pop up. Just take rest here. All right, from here you either can do a couple cat and cows, just something to move through extension and flexion of your spine, or full vinyasa, but we will end up in our sukhasana or some kind of comfortable seat. Eventually making your way onto your seat. Full lotus, half lotus, sukhasana, whatever. Oh yeah, that'd be nice. Face each other. So let's start by taking the hands out onto the knees. The palms can be facing up or down. And then come into your meditative seat. So feel the sit bones grounded. The lower abdomen and belly still engaged to support the spine. The shoulders are down away from your ears and back. The crown of the head is lengthening up. Just work on elongating your breath, smooth inhales and exhales here. Possibly noticing some shifts or changes in the physical body, the mental, the emotional. Breath in this position. Now feel free to stay in your meditation if you'd like, or you're going to lie down onto your back for Shavasana. Allow the feet to flop open, the hands to be wide. Your breath is natural here, but let that be kind of what you're still tuned into. Embracing the silence. Coming to total surrender. maybe a little sigh out of the mouth. Bring some movement back into the body. Wiggle the fingers, the toes, maybe roll out the wrist or sway the head side to side. If you need more time here, of course, you can take it. Otherwise, we'll start to pull the knees into the chest and roll over to one side. And then press yourselves up and take your hands towards your heart. So let's finish our practice with the sound of Om. We'll start by exhaling here. Inhaling together. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Peace, peace, peace. Namaste.
Namaste. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Have a great day.